Okay, guys, Connor 64 here, sorry about that. I know it's been a while last time I made this video. Let's see. This is gonna be like, I think this is like episode 21, I believe. So, if you wanna know what happened last part, watch that. But we're gonna do a type of, we're basically gonna do a time skip. This can be a few months. Deku / Springtrap, he's been feeling weird. Like, his body has been, like, making him sick. And he doesn't know why. He's been doing tests on his body to find out what's going on. Vanny and the others don't know what's going on. I mean, Vanessa, she walks into the room. Hey, Springy, what's up? I'm fine. What is it? The plan to attack UA, is it... Are you sure it's a good idea? It's great! I'm tired. This is all you need to know. The final battle. I will destroy... everyone, including the greatest target of them all, Katsuki Bakugo. Okay. I have all the forces. I have everyone. In a court. It's all planted. It's everywhere. My machine... I fixed it. And Vanny takes something. Vanessa takes something out. What he stabs into his neck. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. He's okay. Vanny, Vanessa, what are you doing? I don't want you to die in this battle. He falls into her arms and she lays him down. She lays him on his, onto a bed. And of course, Dobby. Okay, let's see. Dobby, Toga, and of course, Eri comes out. Dobby's like, are you sure we should do this behind his back? Yes. Hey, I looked at his test. He's mine. After you, whatever the machine plus Ares Quirk did to him, it's making him go insane. Insane? Dobby's like, what the hell? Yes. And... Eri? Leans down and says, can you watch over Springy for me? And she nods,
yeah, I can.
So, yeah. Yeah, get the troops, get everyone. We are going to attack. She puts on the mask. UA. And of course... Of course, the dorms are a thing, like how I already said a couple episodes ago. And it might have been last episode. I can't really remember. I haven't really done it in a while. But they get the troops, and I'm saying this is kind of like the war arc. Like they get all kinds of just plain villains and all that. And except for that, for that one scene in season 5, where, like, in the main timeline where they were joining that one group where they have, like, this Bible type of thing, where they basically want to, I can't remember what their name, but they're gone, They are eradicated, if I remember. So, basically, they even have, Imakia. So, basically, they make him go out to destroy some cities. When some of the heroes are all the heroes are trying to, take down Imakia, All Might, you know, he's still, you know, he still has a bit of his ability, you know. Like, he's not fully retired, but he did give his quirk to... Okay, I'm going to say give it to Bakugo. Yes, Bakugo Katsuki. I was thinking about giving it to Mirio, but then I was thinking he's pretty OP without his quirk, so he has it with me, you know, he gave it to Bakugo. He was thinking who to give it to, so he gave it to Bakugo, you know. Because, you know, Bakugo has been through a lot of shit. He's been changing way faster than he would in canon. Because, yeah, he wants to kill Springtrap, and of course. So he has to just get to the battle. When a bunch of low-rank villains are just going out through the city attacking, people screaming, heroes like Endeavor, all the top-rank heroes except for, like, including All Might's there, some of them, you know, Eraserhead, and all the, and of course, all the students are watching this on live TV, and when this happens, I'm gonna say, okay, I have an idea. Well, no. Well, Itzy. I forgot to mention this. I'm not sure if I did or not. Twice, he's not dead, actually. You know, he never died. He you know, he escaped. And he's dead, but he's not dead at the same time. You know, like, basically he's dead, but not dead. It's basically gonna be kind of confusing. It's like, I'm just gonna say he's dead but not dead. Eve, you know, to go first and, you know, y'all find out what it actually is going on in the future of this what if. And of course, Toga, Dobby, Vanny, and a bunch of clones of them, because, okay, twice, I'm just gonna say now, I wanted to basically make y'all think he died when Shigaraki and all the other villains died, but, you know, he didn't, or whatever, so, yeah. They just found him, you know, they found him, and he joined up with them again. Of course, you know, he's at the base, like, I mean, he's not at the base, but he basically made 1,000 clones of Dobby, like, he made a bunch of clones of Dobby, Toga, and Vanny. So, yeah, when all the clones are just going at UA, I'm gonna say the students, like, it's basically like, okay, people can probably get mad at me for this, but imagine, World War II, where there was a bunch of, you know, the bad guys, like, there was a billion of those bad guys. I don't wanna say the names of them, because I don't wanna get a strike on YouTube. Just imagine a billion of them, you know, just doing that. There's basically a billion of them, of Toga, Dobby, and Vanny, going through UA, attacking the students. Nezu was trying to get help, and, of course, Midnight is there, you know, Midnight, and, I'm gonna say Vlad King is there, you know, they're trying to help the kids. Bakugo and Class 1A join up, Class 1B join up, all the students are trying to fight back. Some of them, who are fucking pussies, run away. You know, fighting, running, you know. Until, the real Vanessa jumps up behind, you know, but I'm gonna say Bakugo was just, you know, she basically got Bakugo by himself, and she's like, what the hell? Take this, you bitch! Does a, sets off an explosion. She dodges it and cuts him. Cuts him on the stairs. She's like, "Girl, what are you?" He's like, you work for that, you work for him. Yes, I do, and you will never, ever hurt my Springy, you bitch. and blow, basically just blowing her, you know. And also, I didn't tell you all this, but she's been making the costume. Okay, she's in this one, she's wearing the costume of what's in Security Breach. Instead of just having the mask, she has the whole costume now. I forgot to mention that, but I did hint at it last episode, but I forgot to mention it. I kind of hit on it a bit. But basically, she has the full costume. She has a knife. She's cutting away. He's exploding, and the costume is kind of ripping. Because, it's, you know, it's not a good costume. It's basically just, you know, fabric, you know, wolf fabric, basically. Basically what, like, the old animatronics from FNAF 1 have. Kind of like that. And, you know, she's cutting away. Her costume gets blown. And let's get back to Izuku. Hours have passed. He's like, ugh, what happened? He's kind of dazed. He's dazed. But he's like, what? He cuts, and, you know, his TV was on, so he goes to breaking news. I can't, what's going on? Of course, you know, a bunch of his robots are out there. He's like, the plan! No. They, those idiots, no, don't worry about them, but we can still make the plan work. And Eri's like, are you okay? And of course, you know, Deku's eyes are like, yeah, he accidentally hits Eri. By accident, because, you know, his mind's going crazy. By accidentally hitting her, he, like, her quirk activates, and basically, what happens is, and with the, you know, with that energy inside of him, and her quirk activating again, it, you know, it kind of does something. It basically fuses, basically, something, what I like to say, this. This is what Izuku starts to look like when something starts to, like, black blood starts to fuse out of him. He's like, what's going on? His mind's fuzzy. Eri's kind of like dazed for a bit. A mirror falls down and Izuku looks at himself. What? My face! It's not broken. My hair. What's going on? Of course, he realizes he's naked, so he leaves, he goes into Dobby's room to get some clothes. And you only see I'm gonna say like a green suit, well, a dirty green suit, kind of like, you know, like what his hair looks like, kind of just imagine that. He goes into the woods, like, something, and of course, you know, he looks like Izuku. In this picture, he doesn't look like Izuku. I couldn't really find a picture what would look like a Springtrap version of Izuku. So, yeah. So, basically, I just went with this picture. This was the best one I could find. And, so, basically, Izuku goes into the world. You know, yeah, he does, you know, looks just like Izuku. Just his skin's more pale. His hair is more of a faded out green. He has like ears now, but he doesn't have a tail, you know. He's just, of course, his body. Okay, basically his body kind of, it's a mixture of flesh and mechanical pieces, kind of, I guess you could say. Like, his hands look like normal hands, just they look like the Springtrap hands, but, you know. And kind of his body does too. Okay, his body looks like a person's body, but kind of looks like how Springtrap looks from FNAF 3. It's a mix. It's a fusion of those two, you know? Okay, what the fuck? It's kind of hard to explain, but it's the best I can go with. I'm sorry. So he goes out, he sees what's going on, and he grabs himself a gun and a knife. And he heads out. But before he leaves, he grabs Eri and lays her in the bed and, you know, kisses her on the forehead and says, "I'm sorry. Something was wrong, and I shall fix it." So he leaves. This has been going on for hours and hours. He's watching the damage of buildings collapsing. He can't help it but smile. His plan is working without him even doing anything. He's just happy. He walks through the streets, just smiling. He grabs a, what he does is, I'm gonna say there's a fan of Springtrap. Someone makes a mask with symbols like Springtrap. He grabs it from the ground. I mean, he grabs a mask that looks like Springtrap's head. He puts it on. Basically, it's like it's not the bottom jaw. It's basically just the top jaw with eyes and all that. He basically just puts it on his head and says, "Let's make some carnage." And just walks through everything. He gets to UA. He walks through. Well, he sneaks through. He sees students fighting, but then he sees Bakugo about to kill Vanessa. But right, like, he sees him. He sees her. He sees her mask gets ripped off. He's in shock. He's like, "What the? Vanessa! You crazy bitch! I'm gonna kill you!" Izuku shoots a gun. Bakugo jumps back. "That's not how you play!" Of course, he hears the same voice. "That's not how you play, Bakugo. It's my game, remember?" He says, "Springtrap, what happened? Well, you like the new me? I kind of like it. I'm not dead anymore. You know?" Vanessa's like, "Izuku." She's like, "Izuku, I don't like you messing with my girl. You might want to back away before this gun, because right before I put it between your eyes and go bang." You hold Buckles like, "You bastard." "Do not worry, God. Do not worry, Bakugo. I told you you will die. And this seems like the final battle, doesn't it? I will rule over everything and everyone. At first, I wanted revenge. And that is all I ever wanted. But then I thought, what am I going to do after I get my revenge? Why not rule the world? Shigaraki failed at it. All for One failed at it. Every villain failed at ruling the world, or tried to do it. But me, Springtrap, will not." And before he can finish anything, Bakugo blasts at him. Izuku just running back, you know, just jumping back, back, back. Then onto like a rooftop, you know, the rooftop of UA, a helicopter on live TV, you know, can basically hear everything. "Do not worry, Bakugo Katsuki." And of course, he Izuku grabs something out of his pocket, presses a button, and across the city, across way far from UA in the city, a Grenchu Machia head explodes. And of course, one of the helicopters, recording the whole thing live, sees his head blow up. What was that for? It's to show the world. I mean business. It's to take care of a little problem. I just needed him to make some chaos. But he's no longer needed. What are you? Have you not been watching the news lately? You. And of course, Nezu gets a hold of All Might, and he tells him everything. The heroes to knock out all the villains. You know, the only villain they couldn't get a hold of is a Grenchu Machia, because you know they kind of really knocked all the villains out. They head to UA. The heroes are there. They're like, and of course they have to defeat all the clones. You know, some of the students have defeated them. All Might jump. All Might's heading to Bakugo. No. So, Bakugo starts to fight Springtrap, who he thinks that, well, they don't know who his true identity is, and, you know, Bakugo's trying to punch Springtrap, is just dodging. Dodging's like, bastard, fight me! You took everything from me! Oh, everything? I didn't take everything from you. You took everything from me. A lot of... I know you want me... You want me dead. And I'm okay with that. Let's see. Okay. Stabs it through his stomach. All Might gets there finally. He says, "Young Bakugo!" And of course, with Bakugo's explosion hitting Springtrap's face, the camera zoom in. The mask breaks up. Deku. And the world sees Springtrap. It's been a while. Oh, you went missing. Died. Oh, but you were. I died, Bakugo. And of course, Izuku starts to explain everything. You little fuck friends. You little fucking little friends from middle school murdered me, and I came back for revenge. When I said you murdered me, I meant it. You murdered me. And now I can have my revenge. All Might's like, you. He's like, you bastard! Does Detroit smash? Blows them both away. Aizawa grabs Bakugo. No, I will kill him. Goes after Aizawa. All Might grabs Izuku, throws him back, and says, young man. You were Springtrap this whole time. And of course, you know, he was talking about his whole life, you know. You. I was quirkless, All Might. Of course, you would never know how that feels. Would you? Oh. Oh, right. I went through All For One's information of you. Toshinori Yagi. All my time. You were quirkless before you got that quirk of yours. I died before anything could happen to me. Fate brought me here. I'm not just gonna kill Bakugo. I shall kill you as well. Number one fake hero. No. Perish and die. Nah, I will not be defeated here. Detroit, I will kill you. Oh, mate.